Mr. Paladin here today with some soldier footage on King of the Hill. No, it's Thunder Mountain. Thunder Mountain, Section 3. And oh my goodness, I come into some trouble right here. Oh, that was a lucky critical. Mercy. Thank goodness there was a medic with me. There's still plenty of enemies around here, though. Medic, come get this health back. Okay. So anyway, I want to show this footage not only because I was killing a lot of things here, but, you know, our team was doing poorly. As you see, the blue team got to Section 3 of Thunder Mountain, and it looks like an engineer's building down there. Ooh, medic heavy coming in. Oh, I keep telling people you shouldn't fire at the heal target, you should fire at the medic, but I already invested a lot of rockets into this guy, and I was hoping to out-damage him. I'd lost my medic in the process. Sorry, med. Anyway, I wanted to show this footage because it's a really good example of one, working with your team to come back. I wanted to see if I could rocket jump up into this window and didn't expect to catch the ledge. I tried to catch the pixel on the way down, but I ended up killing the pyro just by hitting the roof. Anyway, it's not only a good example of working with your team for a comeback, but people have been wanting soldier footage from me, and this is kind of what I do on this section of the map if I want to play soldier. I try to keep the high ground, and I'll often roam from this position over here, because you can shoot down on the payload, to back over by the gate, because there's the ammo packs, and I've got to protect the sentry gun. But as soon as I see that medic, you see, I forget about the soldier and I concentrate on shooting that medic. There we go. We'll worry about the soldier after the medic's dead. And in true Beggar's Bazooka style, you see me often load up three rockets when nothing's around. But this is a good example of what I mean about keeping the high ground. For a half a second there, I had to go AFK. That soldier took several shots at me, but it didn't do enough to kill me, because hitting the high ground is actually hard to do. Demo men can shoot up to the high ground pretty good, but other classes have a hard time. So if you maintain that height advantage, jump on things like these little fences and stuff like that. Oh, poor demo man, he went to charge and then I messed up his charge. But yeah, you keep that height advantage and you'll find the splash damage is hard to hit you. And I don't know why I got this quick fix popped on me, but I tried to move in for the sentry gun maybe when the gate was open, but you know, those lucky criticals reminding you that the quick fix is not really a super uber. Dropping down there to help protect the gun, that pyro head position underneath it. Always take out the engineer before taking out the sentry. So that's what he's doing. He's building down there, looking for a good time to move a level 3 gun out. What a sneaky engineer. But yeah, this was good by our team, because we kind of got rolled in the first section of the map. So the enemy team is not shabby. And you'll see in a moment, they actually overrun this first capture point as well. Oh, I just saw the edge of a spy there. I don't even know how I managed to see him. I see a demo man in front of me, but I also see those pills behind me, so I put some shots in there and I think I kill something with splash damage. Oh, sorry, I bounced around the quick fix. I'm sorry, man, I didn't know you were on me. But yeah, I'm using the gunboats as well, so I'm taking very little splash damage for myself, and that's why you also see me not using any other secondary weapon. I'm just using the fact that people are dropping weapons and there's plenty of ammo up here to just keep this beggars rolling. If I have a pocket medic, I'll sometimes go one of the banners, a buff banner or a conch or something. Lots of action here. Oh, I didn't mean to take this large ammo pack away. And I saw the cloak smoke of that spy too. Saw a glimpse of it on the edge of the screen. So 30 seconds. I think I took his ammo pack again, I'm sorry, man. But you see what I'm dealing with. Again, this is a part where I'm loading up three rockets. I'm offloading there because sometimes demo men and soldiers will jump up to that ledge. And it's what I like to do, especially for sentry guns in the position that we're using it at. And see, I jumped down and it was the death of me jumping down. If I had just stayed my butt up instead of jumping down, we might have held that, but after I died, they moved in, they took out the gun, and that was all she wrote there. So they started pushing it to the next point, And here's something else I like. This set of shelves that is behind me. You'll see a couple times I'll actually shoot through those shelves. It's kind of a nice spot. You watch, I'll load up a few rockets. I'm looking for where that medic is, but see that little gap in the shelves? Oh, come on, go back to the shelves, Mr. Paladin. So, see this gap? Bam, bam, bam. Puts the rockets right through to where that exit gate is. I love it. I use it a lot. It kind of protects me. I can still see if something's coming. Overtime. Okay, that heavy has to get on the payload. And yeah, working together, keeping the high ground. It's what I like doing as a soldier. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.